Hello, I'm Will Zitterich with 3D Distributed, and today we're making a video on how to use mesh bed compensation. Okay, so the first thing you'll want to do is you'll want to set up your probe and you'll want to calibrate it for its trigger distance above the bed. So a great way to measure that is to bring the nozzle down until it's touching the bed manually using the Duet interface, and then bring it up a tenth of a millimeter at a time until the Z probe number, which will be over here, drops from somewhere around 700 to something under 500, which is the trigger distance. And you'll count how many times, how many tenths of millimeters you brought it up, and you'll go to Settings and System Editor, and in the Config page, that will let you set the trigger distance for the Z probe, right there. Once you've had that done, you can then home the machine, which I've already done, and hit G29S0. And that will start the actual probing routine that generates the mesh for mesh bed compensation. So you can see it begins coming down. It's important to have this calibrated, and we'll explain how to program this in the first place if you intend to use a different size bed in a different video. As you can see, it started near the homing switches for Z, Y, and X, and now it's moving backward. It's only moved off the X humming switch a little bit because of the way we have the grid set up. We want to get as much of the travel as possible in the mesh. And it comes down in linear interpolation, just a straight diagonal, and then just a few millimeters off the bed, it'll do a direct straight up and down Z plunge. And as you can see, it's hard to see exactly with the wiring there, but there's a light on the probe, which provides some backup confirmation that you're actually detecting the bed. And it'll probe out this grid. Should probably cut there, because it's going to take a while.